Since the beginning of this year, 2021, the government of Cameroon officially announced the second wave of the deadly pathogen, the COVID-19. We decided to move to some institutions to find out how the barrier measures are being respected, especially on the learners. I'm Clarence Nge. This is the guest on CRTV News. I'm privileged to have with me here the principal of Purpose-Driven High School Oja here in Yaoundé. He is called Mr. Nalyonge Maximilianus Ewoku. He is the principal. He is also a researcher and a philosopher. Greetings to you, sir.
Good morning, sir.
I hope you're strong.
I'm waxing well.
Now, Mr. Principal, since the outbreak of the COVID-19, especially this period of the second wave, what concrete measures have your school been following?
Well, I can say, I can pick it up from this year. It is a pandemic, we all know, and there are prescribed measures stipulated by the World Health Organization and the Cameroon government. So, following the prescribed measures specifically for this milieu, for the school, one, we have the hand washing spots wherein we have running water, then the hand washing buckets, wherein when the learners come, we make sure that they clean their hands, clean their knees well, following the respective methods of each finger, one finger after the other. Then now they go for hand sanitizing, they take their temperature at the entrance. They move to their respective classes or to the assembly ground. Apart from that, we equally have, isolation room, wherein we know have the suspected cases and the infected cases. So normally, it is true, by the grace of God, we have not had any infected case here. But following what we do, we have suspected cases. So what we do with the suspected cases is we try to make sure we assess, we investigate, find out about everything possible. Then, if it is really a suspected case PC, first of all, sent to the isolation room, then we discuss without making the other learners know about it. We can equally recommend, if it's a learner, we recommend that the parents should go for the test. Then bring the result, they have to come and present the results. We have had two cases like that, and the parents came with the result, which was negative. And even an administrator who was suspected, then we, you know, the symptoms, when we have the symptoms, the sneezing, the fever, and all the symptoms we know, we try to send the administrator to go and conduct the test.
Mr. Principal, do students and teachers really respect these barrier measures to the fullest?
In the society, we always have recalcitrant students or persons. At times, we have learners who don't even come with their face mask. At times, you have teachers who even come, they forget theirs. And we created a measure wherein, as a technical and industrial school too, learners produced some face masks. Wherein, if in a case where a teacher has forgotten the face mask, we give the teacher a face mask after even calling at the teacher or calling the teacher to order. We give a face mask to the teacher and even some learners who forget theirs. Those who live around, as a form of punishment, we ask them to go and collect. When we look at the time, we think that it's because they must have their face mask. They must respect the social distancing. Even in classroom, we do our best to put, there are some classes with one per table, then some two respecting the 1.5, 2 meters social distancing. So we do our best. Even before you, after using the toilet, we make sure the boarding master, the boarding mistress, we have the security officers, everyone gets involved in the disciplinary aspect of the organization. Where when they find a student who leaves the toilet without washing their hands, they direct the learner to go and wash their hands. So I will say, in purpose-driven high school, without being hyperbolic, we respect the barrier measures 90%.
We are in a period of the second wave. We want to find out, this virus, is it really creating fear in amongst the students and staff of purpose-driven high school? There's some panic somewhere.
The truth is, the panic occurred when there was like the wave of a second confinement. Yes, the wave of a second confinement. That was when some parents came here and they were like, mad, they don't want it. Their children must go to school. what they faced last year, they don't want to go through it. But we, being in the milieu, we are supposed to have that self-mastery, and we don't panic, because if we panic, what more of the learners? So we try to galvanize the learners. We try to make sure they have a positive spirit. So yeah, we don't have that panic about the second wave. The panic is subjective, specific to individuals, to teachers, but collectively, we do our duty, we perform our duty normally.
Thank you very much, Mr. Principal,
yes, sir,
for talking to CRTV News.
Thank you, Mr. Clarence.
Well, that was an interaction with Mr. Nalionge Maximilianos Ewoko, Principal of Purpose Driven High School, Oja Yaounde. He is, earlier mentioned, he is a researcher and a philosopher too. He actually gave us some insight about how the different barrier measures are being respected in this institution. And of course, he also told us on how a purpose-driven high school, has been performing, as a citadel of learning in order to bring good results and of course train, future Cameroonians who will actually, take us to the dreamland. Thank you for watching, and do stay tuned to more interesting programs on CRTV News. Thanks.